Thank you, Dr. Gopal. The leadership and solo practice nowadays becoming difficult and difficult. Some of the few things I would just like for food for thought. Whenever we mean solo, actually we understand solo means that we are the owner or we are the leader or we are only have the person to take decision. And we will not have any arguments with any of the our superiors or the employer or somebody else. And we feel that we are in control. And we will not have any kind of financial dispute that I am working and somebody else is earning. And I can chart my own path. But these only are the points of learning. What I mean to say, I will talk otherwise, but I will speak for the thing that whenever we feel that we alone or I alone can do anything, that is the biggest mistake. If you want to lead something, you need to have a team. If you want to work efficiently, again you need a team and delegation of work. Whenever you feel that nobody should argue with you, your learning stops. You cannot grow further because you alone can never be a master for each and everything. And when you feel that you are having a full control, actually you are misutilizing your skill, which is practically a skill of a doctor, a skill of an ophthalmologist, and you are wasting your time to something else. We feel that there is no financial disputes, but the financial disputes will only come when you earn enough. If your earning is not enough, you will not have a dispute. And you can chart your path is actually a good thing for solo practice, in which you actually know how to go. Because there are no wrong pressures. I never mean that otherwise you will have wrong pressures, but sometimes there are wrong pressures. So the advantages are that you have a greater autonomy and freedom, and that everybody likes, and I also like, and you will also like. But you can learn the balanced way in which you can maintain your autonomy by asking, discussing, or demanding for the things from a group practice or from a corporate practice or from any practice in which you are not in autonomy, that what all will be allowed, what all will not be allowed, means according to your personality, you can get them customized. We should know the ground realities, and that is an advantage in one way, that you know what are your shortcomings also. But nobody likes to hear our own shortcoming, but that can be an advantage, that rather than somebody else is telling you, if you know your own, you will be having a better time and things to improve yourself. You can have better connect with the patient. This is a kind of pseudo-satisfaction in a solo practice, because you feel that the patient comes in your own name, and that's why you are having connect. Anybody who is working in corporate also can maintain a good connect, because the connect is not because of your skill. Connect is more because of your behavior. And in corporate practice, you have more time to give to the patient, to talk, to communicate, to understand, and to explain, which in solo practice sometimes become difficult if you have a good enough volume. If volume is not there, then better connect will not have any of the value. The good thing with the solo also is that you can have what all is available around the world, within your city, state, or nation, or whatever place, in academics, in technology, or any new thing. But it comes with a very heavy cost. And sometimes this comes as a heavy cost to your time is not given to your family, which should also be on a priority. I myself feel that I would have given more time to my family had I not been in solo practice alone. Sometimes because of this reason, many people who are in solo practice, they actually don't use their full skill or potential for the practice itself. That is a problem. But the good thing is that you can learn everything. Initially, ophthalmology was a kind of thing in which you could do everything. Now, ophthalmology is getting divided into specialties, maybe called a subspecialty or a super specialty. But when you want to develop a skill beyond a normal average, then you need to think that except until you are a very extraordinary surgeon, you actually need to be limiting yourself to one particular specialty. That is one of the advantage and one of the disadvantage. Advantage I mean that you become better than others, so you get more satisfaction in the patient and yourself. The disadvantage that for any other specialty or subspecialty in which you are not dealing, you need to refer a patient out of your hospital, that is a problem of a solo practice. But in otherwise practice where the other specialists are available as your colleagues, you can be having advantage. The disadvantage are that sometime you want to go on leaves, particularly maybe not for vacations kind of thing, but for academic also, you cannot leave your hospital, that is a problem. And there are many challenges which need to be taken care or their burden to be borne by a single person, and that is you only, and otherwise you could have worked for more professional things rather than other burdens. Sometime the team motivates you, but to get motivated self is a difficult job. And sometime it happens, or most of the time I will say that many of the people limit themselves by saying that how much I can do as alone, main akela kya kya kar sakta hun. And once this thought comes in my mind or anybody's mind, his growth is actually hampered. And in a group practice or in a corporate practice or in a college practice in which the access to journals, textbooks, journal clubs, etc. can be of ease, but thanks to the technology with the YouTube and other things, most of the things can now be learned on internet, and that too are free. The basic thing required to be leader in solo practice, you need to be a multitasker. Multitasker means you should be able to do many of the tasks, types of the tasks. At the same time, you should be able to do them together also, simultaneously also. And this is a big problem, because when you try to focus on one thing, the other thing goes out of mind. And when you try to do one thing more seriously, it gives either a stress or others are ignored. And especially in the initial phases, this becomes a real problem. So solo practice, some of the greatest ophthalmologists we know world over, and good thing for ophthalmology that most of the corporate hospitals don't have a renowned ophthalmologist. Most of the renowned ophthalmologists in India and abroad are doing their solo practice. And this is a fool thing also, I will say, because I have to speak in balance. Many of the machines we purchase in solo are difficult to repay, and sometimes some of our colleagues fall into a trap that they have to do a malpractice, which they don't feel themselves. What I mean by malpractice is some of the patients actually don't need a particular treatment, and because we have that particular treatment facility, we try to lure them, force them, make them confused, and maybe through counseling, overselling of the particular technology or a product is not a good thing. So I would like to say that we should maintain that we are not for earning only, because we are professionals and we are kind of a noble profession in which if you want to maintain the dignity, we should not do any wrong things. Because of the time, I will not speak further the slides, but my only take-home message I want to give it, that you alone can also lead, there is no harm, no doubt, but you should maintain your balance of not doing the malpractice, then only you should fall or do solo practice and keep on investing into the technology, machines or infrastructure. But if you feel that this gives you too much of the mental pressure, it starts affecting your lifestyle, then join somebody, it is better. Thank you very much.